Hey, wait, are you trying to do this? Then this is the right place for you. First, go to this GitHub right here, link in the fix comment, and download Keyboard Splitter Xbox. To download it, find the Releases tab by clicking right here. Then, at the date of this video, the most recent version is this one, 2.2. You may need to expand this assets drop-down to show the download options. And then you click right here at the keyboardsplitter.version.zip to download it. Once you download it, extract the zip file and you will get these files here. Then click two times at the executable file. A window like this is going to show up. And here at the top corner, you can choose the amount of controllers you want to use. You can go from 1 up to 4 X-input slots. One thing to pay attention is this here, the keyboards. By default, it tries to pick different keyboards for each controller. But you're probably using just one keyboard on your machine. So let's keep this one and let's change this to two controllers. Okay, let's set up it like this. The first thing you're probably going to notice is that you cannot change the button assignment here. Why? Well, this is kind of confusing at first, but here you have multiple presets, and to create a new preset you just type a new name here that is not in this list. If you use the default preset, you cannot change it. You have to use a custom preset. So now that you created this preset, you can change the buttons. Now I'm going to create a second preset for player 2, and I'm going to map all of these here. Click the save button to create the preset, and I'm going to map all of these, and I'm going to speed up the video. So let's map it. Okay, I finished mapping, and now I'm not going to use the D-pad and the right stick for this demonstration, but you can do it if you want to. I'm just keeping it minimal, and I'm sharing the keyboard for two players. If you're using the whole keyboard just for you, then you can map everything the way you want. It's your choice. And to start running, you just click the start button right here. But before doing that, pay attention to this checkbox here, block keyboards. When this checkbox is marked, your keyboard is blocked. Your keyboard cannot type anything. Every time you press a button on your keyboard, it's going to be mapped to your gamepads only. So if you want to use some chatbox, communicate with someone, send actual keyboard presses, then you have to uncheck this. When this is left unmarked, every time you press the key on your keyboard, it's going to be mapped to your gamepad, and it's going to be pressed on the keyboard too, both of them at the same time. Most games will face issues with that, right? If you press on keyboard and the gamepad at the same time, the game is probably going to recognize the keyboard as a keyboard player too. And you don't want that. You just want the gamepads. So That's why the default behavior is to block the keyboard. But yeah, remember that. Then let's give this a try. Here we have Fatty, the gamepad tester. We have a nice overlay, keyboard overlay at the center of the screen. We have this Windows USB controllers, and we have our keyboard splitter that we are going to run. Let's click Start. And if I press buttons on my keyboard, everything is good. It's mapped just as expected, the way we want it to work. All good. And you can notice here, keyboard splitter has created two virtual controllers. At the operational system level, Windows can see those controllers. You can even see the inputs here that Windows registers. So, perfect. And if you press here the block keyboards, you will see that my keyboard presses don't register. The keyboard stops responding, which is the idea. If I uncheck it again, then it's registered in both of them, the keyboard and the gamepads at the same time. All good, all perfect, just fine. Now you can remap your controllers at Parsec or at any other game. And if you like my content, don't forget to smash the like button, comment, share, subscribe, and check the bell icon to be notified when a new video is released.